Today I'm doing, as you can see, a video that it's kind of a tag video that Samantha March has done. I will link her video and her channel down below. She's such a she seems like such a sweet person. I just had to say that. But yeah, she sorry, I'm charging my phone at the same time. It's moving the camera around. She has this thing where she does like top five, bottom five, and I always like list and everything like that. But she made, I saw this video yesterday, and it's, you know, brands that excite her, you know, when they are announcing a launch or coming out with new stuff. So the top five brands that really excite you, and the top bottom five that, you know, never excite you. And I thought that was such a fun idea, so I wrote down some brands, and it's really hard, but I have decided to, there are a lot of more brands that I get excited by, but I have really tried to take out the five that I'm getting most excited by, and like, and that does not mean that I'm not excited by other brands, of course, but these are the ones that I'm, oh my god, and I almost every time buy their stuff. And now I just realized that I've just put down four brands. What was the fifth? Yeah, I have to check that. But yeah, so there is a lot of brands that are, you know, it's exciting, but not that exciting. I don't buy all their stuff and so on. And the bottom five, I'm not interested at all with brands that are either impossible for me to get or really hard for me to get. And some brands, you know, I can't get at all. And some brands I can only get, you know, the basic stuff, the new stuff never comes here and so on. So I'm not taking in any of those brands, kind of. There is one brand that is maybe on the fence, yeah, so. but the brands I have taken in the bottom ones are brands that I can actually get a hold of, but yeah, that's like never interests me. And if there is something that is something weird, I'm playing with my lipstick. Yeah, and I also thought, after I have mentioned my top five and my bottom five, that I will mention five brands that would be, I think, 6 brands that would be in my top five, but has been thrown out. Yeah, now I remember which brand it was. Yeah, it's great. So I really tried to contain myself. But yeah, let's put it like that. So I think I'm going to start with my bottom five, I think, because that's, you know, boring. And I can start off by saying I have four brands and one category. And the category is all the bougie brands. Like if Chanel or Dior or yeah, I don't even know all the expensive bougie brands. I don't know all the names, but they are absolutely available in Sweden, but they absolutely do not excite me. They are really expensive, and like the things I'm most interested in are eyeshadow palettes and then highlighters and stuff. And I'm sorry, but the most, almost every eyeshadow palette I have tried, because I have tried them from the bougie brands, are so terrible. They often just do, you know, neutral palettes or whatever, and that's fine. But I think they're so bad quality. All of you that complain about Revolution, well, at least they are affordable. Buy a 4-pan palette from Dior and they are terrible? No. And of course there are, you know, what's it called? I was going to say exclusions, but that's not the word. But of course, there are good products, but I'm talking, you know, in the big picture, you know, generally. So, you know, no, oh my God, if I want to pay that much money, I would pay it on another exciting brand. And they are usually just lipsticks, and you know, I know that a lot of you will take offense, but for me, those brands are like old lady brands. It's nothing wrong with being an old lady. There's nothing wrong with liking those brands, but I'm thinking of, you know, the classical pink or red lips with the fancy packaging, that is so heavy that you could kill someone with it, and that just puts a little shimmer on the eyelid and put on mascara. That's my picture. It's not necessarily the correct picture, but that's what I think of them. And the only thing that have excited me in a really long time from one of those brands were the Dior Backstage series, the highlighter palette, but it was so much smaller than I thought, and it has been out of stock for so long that I have now lost total interest in it. I will not buy it if it's not on super sale, but why should it? Yeah, oh, it just gets me wind up, these type of brands. And then I have, speaking of expensive brands, Natasha Denona. I know there's a lot of people who love her stuff, and I can't really say so much about it because I have a palette, the Lila palette I have, and that was okay. I have not used it so many times, but and I also have a little blush and highlighter duo. I think that is all I have, and I'm not impressed for the price tag. I think it's too expensive, and none of the things she puts out has really ex made me. Ooh, the only thing that has made me excited is that, what was it called, a tropical palette or whatever, but everyone says that that's total crap. And then I liked the Lila palette because it's purple shades and some shades in the Sunset palette, but everyone is like, oh no, that's not the good ones, and that just makes me. And I've heard too many bad reviews to be convinced, you know, it's just not exciting. Let's leave it like that. And I'm glad because it's expensive. Then I have Smashbox. I can say like this, the normal things that I get excited about when they are released are eyeshadow palettes, blush, highlighter, sometimes bronzer, or things that are a bit different. I'm not excited about foundations, concealers, powders, setting sprays, brow products. Oh my God, no. That type of stuff. And some brands just release that a lot. And yeah, Smashbox is one of the brands that are, you know, they are famous for their primers, and that is also something I'm not. I think their primers are good, but I'm not excited. The only things I have been excited about from Smashbox are the things that I can't buy. I really wanted the Vlada collection, but the only thing that came here were, or the only thing, everything came here except the two. They were releasing three highlighters, and the one with the least fun packaging they released. I want the other two. Yes, I want them because of the packaging, but I couldn't get them anywhere. Smashbox is sold in Sweden, but they don't get all the stuff. They get a lot, but not all the stuff. And I couldn't find it anywhere. I found one place that ships to Sweden, that had a shipping rate at $50, and then I know I have to pay taxes, so no. So you know, I don't get excited because the things I get excited about doesn't come here. Like the new highlighter with the pre-packaging, I'm not even sure it will come here. So when I hear Smashbox, it's usually, you know, oh, if there is something I get excited about, it will never get here anyway. And they release, their eyeshadow palette is not that good, and the other things they release is like, I don't know. No. Then we have Benefit. I like Benefit. I think they have a fun style, you know, their packaging and you know, I like their aesthetics, if you're going to call it that, but they don't do eyeshadow palettes, and the only eyeshadow palettes they do are like 50 Shades of Neutral. And when they release something new, it's either brow products, and that is so boring to me, or it's like, oh, now we're going to make a deeper shade of Hoola. Okay. Can you please make one that fits me? If you're going to do the same all over, because the lightest shade of the Hoola bronzer doesn't show up on me, and I'm white people, I'm a ghost. So yeah, nothing they release excite me, and they have a lot of stuff that seems cool, like you know the one with I think it's two or three stripes of eyeshadow, and you were going to do like the swipe and put it on, but it never works. I'm not making a lot of sense in this video, but I know what I mean. But yeah, they do not excite me at all. And the last brand is Makeup Forever. I think I have two eyeshadow palettes from them. Never used them. I had a cream eyeshadow, dried up. They are mostly famous, you know. I have their concealer. I love their concealer, but they are like all about foundations and stuff, and they are really expensive as well. Expensive brands do not interest me. But they release boring stuff. Whenever I hear, oh, we're going to talk about Makeup Forever. Okay. I can't remember the last time I saw something that I was excited about. I think that was the, what was that called? A flash palette or something. And that they were not allowed to sell in Sweden. They had it at Sephora, but when I was going in and buy it, they said, oh, we couldn't sell it here because there were some ingredients that were not allowed. And I was like, so you mean they can sell it in the States and not in Sweden? What the hell was in that then? But yeah, that was the only thing that I was remotely interested in. And like I said, I love their concealer. It's my ride or die concealer, but they are not exciting. Okay. Enough of the negative stuff. Now I have five brands. I have four brands that are definitely on this list. There was no question about it. The fifth one or sixth, we'll see. I had a lot of to choose from, but yeah. The first brand is Jeffree Star. I think he releases stuff not too much and not too little. He releases some every month now and then. And you know, what is his brand turning? Is it four or five? I don't remember. But and then he has, oh my God, I'm so bad at this. Six eyeshadow palettes, right? And okay, let's pull yourself together, woman. Okay. The things I like about Jeffree Star Cosmetics. He releases stuff often enough to keep me interested, but not too often that keeps me, oh my God. I love his packaging. It's totally my style. I love it. I love the eyeshadow palettes, the shades, the how he thinks about it, the highlighters, everything. I love it so much. He doesn't release too much that are limited edition. The things that are limited edition, if you want it, you can get it. They only disappear after, you know, months has passed. So if you don't get the stuff at when it's released, you can get it later on. It's not too late. It's just the fact that you won't have it first, but if you live in Sweden, you will never have it first. So and he has good retailers you can buy from, his own site, from Beautylish, which is a very good site. You can buy it from Beauty Bay and Morphe, you know. And they are released all at the same time. You can get it everywhere in the world at the same time. I love it. I love it. And I always get excited. I won't be that excited. It's so fun because he has talked about releasing a concealer, and I was like, no, okay, I won't get that because I don't use concealers. But then when I saw the packaging, I was like, okay, I have to buy the concealer because I love the packaging. Yeah. So that is absolutely one of the brands that I get most excited by. And then we have ColourPop. I order a lot from ColourPop, even though I have to pay taxes for it. But since it's so affordable, I think it's worth it. It's annoying, but it's worth it. And they release a lot of stuff, just like the other brand I'm going to talk about. And I know that can be annoying and for some people. And stressful, but I just think it's fun when things happen and when there's new stuff and so on. I don't buy all of their stuff. I've tried most of their stuff with except for the complexion things because but I like that they have for a while they only put out like brown things, but now they have more colorful things and I just get so excited, and if there is something they release that is not that exciting, I know that it will take a week and they will release something else that is exciting. I'm always curious about what they're going to release, and it's really affordable, and I really like their stuff. I love them. And it's also available for everyone at the same time. But my only wish is that it will come to Beauty Bay or something like that before we have to pay taxes for, that as well. But so it will be a lot easier. But yeah, I really, really like them. And then as I don't think that will be a surprise, but it's not a very I think a lot of people will have this brand on their bottom five, I think, but I stand by that I have Revolution, Makeup Revolution, or Revolution Beauty, or whatever you want to call it. I Heart Revolution, I Heart Makeup, whatever, all their sister brands. I love them. They also put out stuff like almost every week. There is always something for everyone. They have really upped their game with the quality because people have complained. I don't hear people complain about, other cheap brands that don't have good quality, but ever since Revolution did a lot of dupe things, they got on a lot of hate. They got a lot of hate. And I understand that. I don't agree with you, but I understand it. But that doesn't mean that everything is bad, and you are allowed to like the brand. I really like that they are doing collabs and they continue to do their thing, even though a lot of people hate on them. And I really think they have a lot of good stuff. And the things that is not amazing are okay. And that I think is okay when it's not expensive. And the things that are amazing, they are amazing and cheap. So I don't know. I like them. I will stand by them. The owner is not in a lot of drama either, so I don't know. But they just get a lot of hate. And it's okay to not like them, but be relevant. And then we have UVS Place. I like their palettes. I have them all. Even the neutral ones, because I think they are really pretty, and I also want good quality neutrals. I use them sometimes, and if I'm going to do makeup on others, it's good to have. They are affordable. They release mostly eyeshadow palettes, which is one of the things that excite me, but they also have blush and highlighter, and they are really I like that they are, it's not the white people that comes first, so I'm not used to buying, a highlighter that is volume 3. I'm always volume one, the lightest shade, but they have the other way around. I think that is so cool. But they always excite me. I like their stuff, and they are also much more easy to get a hold of. They release for everyone at the same time because you can buy from their site, but that's expensive for me. But they eventually get to Beauty Bay, not the highlight or some blush, but the palettes get to Beauty Bay eventually. So that's good. Those are the four brands that are really, really, really they have really deserved to be on this list. The next one is it changed a bit, but right now it's a mix between Blush Tribe and Certify. I know that they are not the same brand, but they kind of excite me in the same way because I really like their eyeshadow palettes. It kind of annoys me that there is one eyeshadow palette I don't have, that I didn't buy from Blush Tribe, and now it's sold out, but I guess it's for the best because it was really neutral. But yeah, it looked so pretty when people used it. But yeah, they do fun stuff. Both the brands do fun stuff and colorful stuff, and are okay price. The palettes are okay price, but the shipping included, and then yeah, it gets expensive. So it's not a cheap brand. They are not cheap brands, but I don't think they are expensive either. But yeah, right now, that are two brands that really excite me, I think. Yeah, I'm going to stay with that. So it's not five, it's six. If I have to choose between Blush Tribe and Certify, I think I would choose Certify, but they don't release stuff as often. And I have not ordered the new palette, the blue, is blue green, because I'm waiting so I can buy more than one palette at once for the shipping. But yeah, I'm really excited about the neon palette from Blush Tribe and the pastel one that is coming. Okay, I know I can't choose between them. Yeah. And now I have some brands that, if you ask me like a year ago, maybe, or 6 months ago, no, I think more than like a year before, I would have totally put them on this list, but they are not now for different reasons. One of the brands is definitely Kat Von D. I love her aesthetics. I love her. It's good quality. I like it all, but you know, for one thing is all this vaccination thing that, of course, I think it's stupid as well. And how she handles that, even though that's the private stuff, but it's so stupid, and it takes, you know, a lot of the fun out of it. But mostly it's like the stuff she has released after that mess has not been that exciting. The vegan palette that released recently is colorful, but I don't know why, but I didn't get excited. And that's so weird because I never get tired of rainbow palettes and colorful palettes and so on, but I don't know. I was not excited, and I'm not sad that I will, if I will miss it. And it's the same, you know, the Mi Vida Loca or whatever that palette was called. I got interested in those types of brands too late, so I haven't that palette, and that has always annoyed the crap out of me. But now I'm like, I don't care. The only palette I care about from her that I would really like is the Pastel Goth palette, because I really love pastels, and that palette I would really like. And that did not come to Sweden or anywhere I could buy it, so yeah, not all of her stuff comes here, and that is the one I'm really annoyed that I don't have, but you know, I live. But otherwise, I'm getting tired of her, and the Lolita palette looks really pretty, but it doesn't excite me the same way. And that's kind of sad. I hope that changes and that she will change. The other brand is Urban Decay. I love Urban Decay and I loved Urban Decay, but recently they have just, you know, I can live with the Naked palettes not being that exciting because they are neutral and has always been. I just hope that they came out with, you know, Naked Forest or Naked Blueberry or whatever, but that will never happen. So I can live with those. The only palette that, yeah, the new Naked palette, I don't know if I will buy it actually. I don't like the packaging and I don't think it's so pretty. I swatched it in store, so I think it looks, you know, good quality wise, but you know, I don't know. It doesn't excite me at all. And it annoys me so much that they have things that I can't get a hold of. Like, I really wanted the Alice in Wonderland palette, the latest one, and I really wanted the Wizard of Oz palettes. And then the one they had for Christmas, the, oh, what was that called? Not astrological, what was it called? But it was round, I think. I have been looking for that forever and I haven't seen it, and now you can't get it. I would like the Game of Thrones palette, just because I think it looks fun. I don't mind bulky packaging at all, but the colors doesn't excite me, and I don't know, it's like a 50-50. Half of the stuff does not excite me, and the stuff that excite me I can't get a hold of, and I think that's boring. And the same with Too Faced. I really like their stuff, but all the things that I get so excited by, I can't buy. It's like Too Faced. I have a pile of money. I want to give it to you, but where are you? It's like the Tutti Frutti collection. I will buy the whole damn collection, but I can't. I can't buy it because Too Faced doesn't ship international, and not to Sweden at least. And Sephora in other countries don't ship to Sweden. And the sites that I have found that have some Too Faced products don't have the new ones either. And the Sephora in Sweden get like some Too Faced stuff. You know, we got the, what's it called? The gingerbread palette, whatever. That was so weird, but we usually get the Christmas palettes. But like the white chocolate one, the clover palette, the stuff we get here like a year after, and it's so annoying because there are so many things I want to buy, and I guess it's good for my, you know, my wallet, but I really want it and I can't get a hold of it, and that annoys the crap out of me. So whenever someone says that Too Faced go and release new stuff nowadays, I'm like, okay, good for them. But yeah, but otherwise I like them, and I'm going to stop being negative soon. But Sueva is one of the brands I really like. I like their eyeshadows, they are really good, but now I have almost every palette they have released that are in, you know, the same format with, what is it, like 10 or 12 eyeshadows, I don't remember. But now it's like, even I think they are kind of repetitive, and it's like, do something else. Because I have, why do I have like 20 palettes of them from them? And it's not like they have one pastel and one more colorful and so on. They are really pretty, don't get me wrong, but it's nothing new, it's not exciting. The only reason I buy them nowadays are for collecting purposes because I am that kind of person. So they don't excite me as much anymore. And then I have Linda Hallberg. I really, 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 really like her stuff. And I used to be really, 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 really excited about her releases because her eyeshadow palettes and her eye crayons and everything, and her brushes. I would love them. But the recent releases she has done do not excite me at all. And it's like powders. That does not excite me. She had released some lip products that don't excite me at all. Then she had an oil and then what was it called? Glass thing that you were supposed to have on your lips or on your eyelids, whatever. And then an eyeliner. And then what was it more? It's not exciting. I bet they are fantastic. And she seems like a fantastic person. But the kind of, five latest releases are like, meh, okay, I will not get it. So that's not why she's on it. And the last brand that should be on my favorite list but are not anymore are Melt Cosmetics. And that's because I get excited by their releases, but it annoys me how hard it is to get a hold of them. And if I buy the stuff at release date, I can get them, but if you want free shipping, you have to buy for over $100 on their site, and then I will also have to pay taxes. And that's why I like to wait and, buy a lot of stuff at the same time. Now they have reached Beauty Bay, but the new stuff don't get there. I don't know why. And I would have loved to have the blue stack in the blue packaging, but that came and went, and now it's out of stock forever. The same with the Smoke Sessions palette, and I know a lot of people have had this experience with the Gemini palette and the 27. They get it, and it's so small quantities that it's sold out, and then it's sold out forever, and then it does come back, and it's sold out again, and that is, I don't think that is good work. Make enough. It's fine that it's sold out, but you can't wait like 6 months to get a restock. I don't know. And I would really like the new stack as well. And there is another thing I would like, but I can't remember. But yeah, they are all out of stock. And if one thing will ever get back, I will not buy it because it's too expensive. I will want to buy all of them at the same time, and that will not happen. So I think it's too complicated to buy from them. And now it feels like I have been negative for 30 minutes. Usually you should have the positive, the negative, and then end with the positive. I started with the negative, and then I had a positive in the middle, and then I ended with the negative. Well, that was maybe not a good idea. But I just get so, what's it called? Emotionally involved. I have a lot of opinions, and I don't have anyone to talk about them with here. So that's why it's coming out like this. But yeah, that's just my opinions. You are of course allowed to have your own, so we can discuss, and it's fun that people think different. And I don't get frustrated when people like don't like Revolution. I just think that some people are going on a trend that, oh, we bash them because of the bashing. It's just like, I work in the finance industry, and there is actually a term called bank bashing, and I don't know why that is allowed to happen, but let's not go into that. Let's stop there. We don't talk about it because I will get so annoyed. Yeah, so that was all for this video, and don't forget to check out Samantha's. I'm going to link it down below. She's more positive. So yeah, bye.